This is Sheshachalam from Astrogate Mysore. Today, let us understand the Kendras, the Trikonas, the Upachayas. I have been talking these words, I have been speaking about these words. So, let us understand the meaning of these words, where actually the placements are placed and how it is to be done. So, the Kendras, I have taken both the charts here, the North Indian style and the South Indian style, so that people can relate, because many of them are not able to understand the South Indian style immediately. They can't catch it. So the Kendras, the North Indian style is like this. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Here the signs will keep moving. The houses are fixed. This is always the first house. This is always the Lagna in the North Indian style. But it is not always Aries. As of now, when I have put number 1 here, that means it is Aries. So the number which has been put in this box is the ascendant and the sign in which the ascendant is falling. For example, if I have put 4 here, that means it is a Cancer ascendant. So ascendant is always fixed in this place. In South Indian chart, it is not like that. The whole signs are fixed. All the signs, Aries, Taurus, Gemini, this is fixed till Pisces. And the ascendant keeps shifting as and how it moves. If the degree is 4, sorry, for 4th sign, then the ascendant will be here. Okay, let us now understand what are Kendras and Trikonas. Now, I have taken this as the Kalapurusha chart, that is Aries is the ascendant as of now. Okay, in this also Aries is the ascendant, and also this Aries is the ascendant. For the Aries ascendant. So, for every other ascendant, it will keep changing and it is applicable. So, the first, the fourth, so if this is the ascendant, this is what I was trying to tell. If this is the ascendant. So, anyway, in this I don't have to put this, because every time this particular house becomes the house of the ascendant. So, the first, the fourth, the seventh and the tenth houses are called as the Kendras. The first, the fourth, the seventh and the tenth are called as the Kendras. So, if I can draw a square here. This is how it is. It is the Kendra. So the first, the fourth, the seventh and the tenth, they are called as the Kendras. So I just drew it so that you can understand how it is. So the fifth and the ninth, the first, the fifth and the ninth is known as the Trikona. So you get a triangle here. You get a triangle. So the first, the fifth and the ninth. Here it is the first, the fifth and the ninth. Very clearly you can see in the North Indian style, this is more apt with regard to Kendras, Trikonas, because all the four Kendras are very close to each other. You can easily relate it. The Trikonas, you can see the Trikonas here. 1, 5 and 9. So these are the Trikonas. So after the Kendras, the next set of four Rashis are known as the Panapharas, and the next other than that is known as the Apoklimas. So what are they known as? The first set is known as the Kendras. Second set is known as the Panapharas. All these Kendras are all called quadrants only. So this is the first set of quadrants, which is known as the Kendras. The second set of quadrants is known as the Panapharas. So they are the 2, 5, 8 and 11. This is 1, 4, 7, 10. Then is Apoklima. Apoklimas, they are known as 3, 6, 9 and 12. So these are the houses. The third, the sixth, the ninth, the 12th house is known as the Apoklima. This is the Panapharas. This is the Kendras. So I have written it in different colors for you to easily understand. The second, the fifth, the eighth and the 11th are the Panapharas. The third, the sixth, the ninth and the 12th are the Apoklimas. So let me go ahead. So I have told you what is a Trikona or the Trine. In English, we call it Trine. T-R-I-N-E. Or which is also known as a Trikona. Trikona, that is the first, fifth, and the ninth signs. 159. So, Upachaya Sthana, the house of growth. These are the houses, which is the third, the sixth, the tenth, and the 11th. The third, the sixth, and the tenth, and the 11th from the ascendant. Be careful. Don't think that it is the Gemini sign or it is, any other sign. It is from the ascendant. So, the third, the sixth, the tenth, and the 11th. Here in the North Indian style, this is the third house always fixed here. This is always the third house, the sixth house, the tenth house, and the 11th house. These houses are fixed. Here it is not fixed. Depends on the Lagna. So, what is that? Upachaya. Upachaya sthanas or Upachaya houses are the 3rd, 6th, 10th and the 11th. Okay. So, these are the houses of growth. The strongest Upachaya is the 11th house and that is why it is called as the house of profit or which is called as the Labasthana. So, next Sthana which you have to understand, because these words, terminologies, I am trying to explain the terminologies, because suddenly when we are doing the yogas and if I keep telling that if a planet is in the Dusthana, you will ask me what is a Dusthana. So what are Dusthanas or Triksthanas? So Dusthanas or Triksthanas. We have some peacocks here with us. Beautiful, they keep coming very close to our place. So, you'll be listening to a lot of bird noises, and it's not a noise, it's beautiful music. So, Dusthanas or Triksthanas are the 6th, 8th, and the 12th houses. 6th, 8th, and the 12th houses. And why are they called Dusthanas? Is because 6th house is also having one of the major negative karakatva, which is Roga. 8th house, desires, dissatisfaction, litigation, humiliation, and what else you want. It is Randrasthana. And 12th house, I have given you the details. 12th house has a lot of negatives like loss, like hospitalization, wasteful expenses, wasteful travel, waste of time. So that is the 12th house. So that is why we call them as Dusthanas or Triksthanas. So when I tell Dusthanadhipati, this is the terminology which I will be using earlier in the next classes, sorry, in the future. Dusthanadhipati means those lords of those houses which are the lords of the 6th, 8th and the 12th houses. Here it is 6th, 8th and the 12th house. So I will be calling it as the lord of the malefic sign or Dusthanadhipati. Okay. So next, what are Badhakas? So this is it will take a little bit of time. So we need to understand three levels here. There are three types of rashis, as I had explained earlier: chara, sthira, and dvisvabhava. So there are three types of rashis: chara, sthira, dvisvabhava, which is the movable. That is, Aries is movable. Sthira, this is Chara, Sthira, Dvisabhava, the same thing gets repeated, C, S, D, Chara, Sthira, Dvisabhava, Chara, Sthira, Dvisabhava, and Chara, Sthira, and Dvisabhava. We have spoken about this in our earlier, I think, first or second class. So now, I think in the second class we have spoken about this when I was doing about the class, just started the class, these are the basics. So, for the Chara Rashi, the 11th Lord becomes a Badhaka. That is, the 11th Lord. So, for a Chara Rashi, the 11th Lord becomes a Badhaka. For this ascendant, this Lord becomes a Badhaka. This is the North Indian style. So, if it is 4th house, that is Cancer, that means the 2nd Lord becomes a Badhaka. So, you should understand that. This is in a different manner. North Indian style is in a different manner. People, North Indian people can very easily relate. So, for Chara Rashi, the 11th lord becomes a Badhaka. And not always Chararashi is here, it is somewhere else also. So for the Chararashi, this is the Badhaka. For this Chararashi, this is the Badhaka. For this Chararashi, this is the Badhaka. So the 11th lord is the Badhaka. For Sthira Rashis, that is for Taurus, Leo, Scorpio and Aquarius, the Badhaka is the 9th lord. So, for Sthira Rashis, the Badhaka from that ascendant, the 9th lord from that ascendant, if the ascendant is Sthira Rashi, then the 9th lord will become a Badhaka. What is a Badhaka? A lord, the planet which will become an obstacle, which will pose hurdles, which will pose challenges to the person in his lifetime. So, for Sthira Rashis, it is the 9th lord from itself. So, for this Svabhava Rashi, for these four corners, this Svabhava Rashi means all these four corners, the opposite sign lord, the lord of the opposite sign becomes the Badhaka. Say for example, it is the 7th lord. Opposite means 7th lord. So, for Gemini, Sagittarius, that is Jupiter becomes Badhaka. For Virgo, once again, Pisces, Sagittarius, that is Jupiter becomes Badhaka. For 9th Lagna, that is for Sagittarius ascendant, Gemini is the 7th sign, so Mercury becomes the Badhaka. And hence for Pisces, the 6th sign, that is Virgo. So Mercury becomes the Badhaka once again for Pisces. So that is about Badhakas. Now to explain about Marakas. So, there are three levels of understanding Marakas. This is the first level through the sign. Then the Drekkana and the Navamsha, that I will come afterwards when I am explaining the Drekkana and the Navamsha. So, the first in the sign, we all know that the 8th house is known as the Ayusthana. Ayu means longevity. So, 8th house is longevity. Ayusthana. So, the house of loss for Ayusthana, that is the house which is behind, which will be keep on pulling its leg, it will try to destabilize and try to make it weak and lessen the strength of this house, is the 7th house. That is the primary Marakasthana. That is, for Marakas, it is the 7th lord and the 2nd lord. And why it is 2nd lord? When we do the bhavat bhava to understand the ayu, that is from ayusthana, the next ayusthana is the 8th from it, that is from 8th. We will count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So, this is also the sign which represents ayu, the 3rd house. So, the 12th from the 3rd house is the 2nd house, which also becomes the primary Maraka, the secondary Maraka. This is the secondary Maraka and this is the primary Maraka. These both are very strong and the strongest is the 2nd lord. 7th lord is primary. For starting, it will start. The 2nd lord is the one which actually kills. So, we call these as Marakas. And there are many antidotes to Marakas, so please don't think that every time Marakas will, whenever the dasha of a Maraka will come, the person will die. Nothing like that. And also, there are many Rashis and ascendants where the 2nd lord does not become the Maraka. It goes to the Drekkana level or the Navamsha level. We have to go there. We have to go to the Khara Drekkana and the Mrityuamsha. So that we will see later. But here, because the 8th house is Ayu, the 7th becomes the Maraka, and because the 3rd house is the 8th from the 8th, the 2nd house becomes the Maraka. So, you should understand here that all these planetary placements in these houses will start giving you different type of results. So, you need to understand these terminologies, and whenever I tell Trikona, you should immediately relate it to 5 and 9. Along with that, 1 is also there. So, 1 is having both the qualities of being a Trikona and also a Kendra. So, nothing else. You don't have any other placement there. So, it is all Trikona and Kendra.
When it is posited
there in that place, only then it makes some difference. So we will discuss about it later. But still, these terminologies are very important for you people to understand. If when I am doing the yogas, if I go into some terminologies, please do not get confused. Practice, then you will understand that what is a sthira rashi, what is a chara rashi. If I keep telling that a fast moving planet in a chara rashi is more unstable than a fast moving planet in a sthira rashi, you should be able to understand this sentence. If I tell a slow moving planet in a sthira rashi is a good muhurta for building a house rather than a fast moving planet in a chara rashi, you will totally go blank if you don't know what is chara, sthira, fast moving planet, and you know, you should understand all this. So, thank you very much for today's class.
So, one more point.
Yeah.
Kendradhipatya Dosha.
Yeah, there is one point which I left out. Thank you. So, it is Kendradhipatya Dosha. So, all Kendradhipatis, I have been telling Kendradhipatya Dosha, this particular word, when I was explaining to you about the four corners. But I did not tell you that Kendradhipatya Dosha exists for every ascendant. The 1, 4, 7, 10. These lords, the first 1, 4, 7, 10 will always get Kendradhipatya Dosha if they do not own a Trikona also. I'll give you this explanation. If a planet is having a Kendra, then is also an owner of a Trikona, then it will not be there. For example, for this Lagna, that is Libra, we have Saturn as the fourth lord, so that means it has to give rise to Kendradhipatya Dosha, but it will not give rise to Kendradhipatya Dosha, it becomes a Yoga Karaka. Why? Because it is also the fifth lord. So, that is one thing. Secondly, there is only one exemption rule here, that Sun, though it is a Kendradhipati, will never acquire Kendradhipatya Dosha. Or, there is one more dosha called as the Asthamsthanadhipati dosha. That is the eighth lord which gets dosha. But Sun has an exemption that though it becomes the eighth lord, for particularly Capricorn Lagna only it becomes the eighth lord, it will not show the Asthamadhipatya dosha. So these are the doshas. And there are many other small things that one of my students, followers were asking this question that when Saturn is posited in the 11th house for Aries, it is a good placement because it is a Mula Trikona, but it is also a Badhaka, 100%. There are so many cases and so many instances when a planet even gets exalted in a 7th house, but it is a Badhaka. So it happens. So for example, for the Pisces Lagna, Mercury gets exalted in the 7th house, but it is a Badhaka. So, good times, that does not mean that bad things cannot happen. So, I'll just give you a small story before I close this. A person was, was a very poor guy. He did hard work. He came up in life, you know. And when he comes up in life, he goes to a level where he first time sits in the flight. That means you should be happy that he has done extraordinary things in his life. God has blessed him with wealth. He has become successful. His time is very good. But that doesn't mean that there should not be a plane crash. All those people who die in plane crashes are not two people who are all are not poverty stricken. They all have money to buy a plane ticket to go abroad or somewhere else. So, when they are in good times, Maraka can act. A Badhaka can do something wrong. That is, you are wealthy, you want to buy a place, you go there without knowing the, you know, pros and cons. You go, you pay the amount, you take the papers of the, plot, you know, the site or the plot or the land, and then after 2 months you come to know that it is litigated. That is the Badhaka. There is when Badhaka starts acting. So, please don't think that Badhakas, if they become Yoga Karakas or if the Badhakas are placed in good places, that they will always give you good. Good things will be happening. It doesn't mean that bad things should not happen in between. They happen. So that is what is the work of the Badhaka and the Maraka and many other Dosha Adhipatis which are there who give Dosha, like the Kendradhipatya Dosha, which actually does not make, you know, let a person unfurl himself and bloom properly in life. It will, you know, it will give in confidence, less confidence. It will make the person go through too many mental blockages which will not allow him to open up himself and live a free life. Thank you very much for today's class.